Hello everybody, I'm Harry Simons, the Customer Success Manager at Joiin, and today I'll be talking through a little guide to custom reporting. So to begin this process, head on over to Custom Reports. So Custom Reports is a way to create fully customized and tailored reports for your reporting needs and preferences. Up here we have a little bit of information about some of the options within Custom Reports. So you can see here we can add charts, create groupings, custom formulas, and then reordering and hiding accounts. Any custom reports that you've created previously will be listed down here, which are essentially templates that can then be opened up month on month and applied to different months, companies, and reporting data. So what I will do is I will begin by starting a custom report from fresh, using some of the functionality within custom reports, and then I'll show you a report that I created previously. So to begin, I will press Add Report, and I'm going to choose Profit and Loss for this instance. So first, within custom reports, we'll have to give our report a name. So I'm just going to call this Management P&L, and then I'm going to save that one. So do ensure as you go through that you're regularly saving so you do not lose any data. So first, we will create a chart. So this chart is going to show us our revenue versus expenses. So we'll call it Rev versus Expenses. We can then choose the chart type. So we can choose between bar, donut, and line. And in this instance, we're going to choose a line chart. We can then select which series are included within this chart. So we're going to choose revenue and expenses, click off that one, accept, and then we're going to save, and then we can run this report. So now we've run this report, you can see here we've got our revenue versus expenses line chart, and this is going to be broken down by month. So the data series will be comparing any of the comparison options you have up here. So you can see here we have 9 comparison periods shown on our report. So what we can do now is we can go back into the report by pressing Edit Layout. So we'll now create a formula. So we're going to create a gross profit formula here. So gross profit will, by standard, be included in your P&Ls, but we're just going to use it for this example. We've then got a couple of options here. So we can hide the formula if we want to kind of have it in the back end. Hide if zero, so if the account equals to zero, it will be hidden. Style as account, which will make the account line appear as just a single group in small formatting, and then a page break as well can also be added. We can then choose result formatting, so we can have it in a number format, financial format, or percentage. We're going to choose financial, and then we're going to enter in the gross profit calculation, so revenue, subtract, cost of sales, and then we're going to accept that one. We can save and run our report. And now, as you can see, we have the gross profit formula at the top of our report as well. So what we can do now is we can press Edit Layout and go back into the report editor. And finally, we can create a new group. So the grouping tool is very powerful within Joiin. It allows you to move reports around, remap your chart of accounts, and just fully customize the report. So in this example, we're going to create a subgroup for our revenue account. So we're going to call this sales revenue. We're going to press new group. We're going to call this sales rev. We've got a couple of options here. Again, we've got the show total, which allows you to create a subtotal of this group. The collapse and show total, which we're going to tick. And this just makes the account appear as a single line item on your report, which you can then expand out. We then have the style as account, which will make it appear as if it's a single account within your report, which we're going to choose. And then you can choose to apply credit or debits as positive, and we're going to leave credits as positive. We're going to accept that one. So now we've created this subgroup. What we can do is we can go and move it to where we'd like it to be within the report. So we're going to click this three dot menu here. We're going to choose to move, and then we can choose the order that's presented in the report, so above or below different groups, or we can move it within another group. So we're going to move it to the revenue group. You can see now it's kind of nested in nicely underneath revenue. So we're now going to select which accounts we'd like to put within this group. So we're going to tick sales, consulting, rev, and rev 2. We've now ticked these ones. So what we can do now is we can press bulk move and move these ones within sales revenue. We can then save this report and run. And then if we scroll down slightly, you can see that we have our revenue group here with our newly created sales rev group. And you can see the little down arrow which we can press, and we can see the individual accounts that are hidden in between here. So that's a very quick introduction to custom reports and some of its many functionalities. We do always recommend having a play yourself within custom reports. And what I'll do now is very quickly show you a custom report that I've created previously, just to give you an idea of what you can create within custom reporting. So here we have a slightly more mature custom report with our revenue group, with some additional subgroupings. We have a nice bar chart here, some customized and collapsed groups. We have one of our donut charts, and then finally a line chart as well. So thank you very much for watching this video. Again, I do encourage you to have a go at custom reports yourself, and please reach out if you have any questions. Thank you very much. Goodbye.